I have to say that you guys need to stop playing with my feelings, because when I posted my Everybody album reaction, you guys told me that would be the last one that he was gonna produce for a really long time. But yet, here we are. Anyway, I've listened to the Everybody album. I've listened to Under Pressure. I haven't listened to the first part of Bobby Tarantino. So I kind of feel like a fake fan right now listening to part two. I just really haven't had time, but you guys really want me to react to this and film it. I'm excited, honestly. Bobby has been killing it. I'm so excited, even though I was late to the party, to be here and support this man. Let me give him all my coins. You know the drill. Anyway, let's get into this. The first song is Grandpa's Spaceship.
Pick something I would be willing to listen to.
Whoa, what about logic?
Logic?
You're not fucking with logic, bro.
No, bruh. Bruh. Hey,
calm down. Of course I love logic. Who doesn't like logic? I mean, you're gonna be a fucking idiot if you don't like logic.
But word.
What are we talking about? Mixtape logic or album logic?
What does it matter? I mean, logic is logic.
Morty. Matters very much.
I don't know, Rick. I mean,
oh?
That I'm in the mood to turn some shit up, Morty. You know, I'm not in the mood for a message about how I can be whatever I want or, you know, like equality and everybody and all that shit, all right? You know, give me some of that Bobby Tarantino shit. You're talking about logic, you know, and I'm talking about that titty rap. Just why don't we meet in the middle with some Bobby Tarantino? You know, I need it.
Here, I'm gonna throw this Bobby Tarantino shit in.
Yeah, drop that shit.
I think it's really funny that he included that in his album, because I even remember when I posted my Everybody reaction video, how many comments were talking about how his mixtapes were better and he's just trying to push this message too much and that's all he talks about and blah, 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 blah. So for him to be so self-aware of that and put it in the album, that makes me think he's gonna try to blend the Everybody album and his old mixtapes together. I'm nervous because, again, I haven't listened to the first Bobby Tarantino, so... Rip? No, I'm married, ho! Okay, this shit slaps, let me tell you. True that. Listen, everybody thinks like you gotta step on people, and if you have more numbers then you're a better person and you can treat people like you can talk down to them. No! This chorus is so good. This is such a strong start. Wow. I'm so ready to get my ass in the air. If this is what the mixtape is like, damn, I need to get on that. Yeah, bitch, I've been blowing up. Bitch, I've been blowing up. Everyone's showing up. Where was you in the beginning? I knew that it's showing up. I'm sorry, I wasn't here, bitch. Something of the business while you at the party. Ain't one to flex, but yeah, I'm finna flex. I just parked that new I8 right next to the Audi. Cop that G-Wagon right there for my side. Yeah, now they know the name, yeah, they know Audi. Think about this, like that I'm living, you never... Why do I love him so much? I don't get it. Okay, usually, like, if you know me, when I listen to hip-hop or rap or whatever, I get so annoyed easily with people who are flexing and all this and all that. Like, cool, I get it, whatever, you're hot shit. But hearing Bobby talk about it, I'm like, hell yeah, bitch. Talk about your achievements. Celebrate the fact that you did that. Again, I haven't been here very long, but I think with Bobby, he's just that person that no matter when you come into his story, I guess you can say, his life, his music, you just want to support him wholeheartedly. And that's rare. I'm just saying, there's not very many artists where you get into them and you immediately just want to support them and see them do great. I have to say real quick, the production so far is so good. I hear a lot of influences or a lot of sounds that I heard in Everybody, but not to the point where I'm hearing it and I'm thinking, oh, it should have been on that album or anything like that. It sounds like a really good continuation in his music and his sound. Wait, Bobby, did I fucking hear that right? Ahead of my time, now my whole motherfucking discovery is already finished. What do you mean by that? You said, okay, Bobby, listen. I was told last time your discovery was finished, but yet we're here. So what is the motherfucking truth, okay? I know you're writing a book and you're doing this and you're doing that, but holy shit, stop playing with my emotions. You cannot keep saying that. I'm gonna live in ignorance and bliss and just imagine that you already have 5 more albums ready. And that's what you mean by that. Because you're not done, bitch. I'm sorry. I'm not done, so you're not done. What an asshole. Bobby become fucking Adele? Okay. Yuck. I'm real curious about this one just from the title alone. Sounds like a horror movie.
Ms. Paul Rothenberg, attorney at law, and I hereby ratify and confirm that Logic is motherfucking paid.
Always on time cause my eyes is on my rodeo. Who is he? Someone, Jess, come collect your man. That Logic isn't here. Is he okay? This makes me think, is he purposely separating the two personas, or is he playing off of it because that's what people have made it to be? People put Bobby as, I mean, he kind of talked about in the beginning, Bobby as his hype man with what did they call it in the beginning, like titty music, I don't remember, but that's Bobby. And then Logic is the one that spreads only messages of love and positivity and self-awareness and confidence and this and that. So I don't know, that's real interesting to me. Okay. Yeah, they pray and I respond. If I ever did, I'd get you in this game with no respawn. Peace, love, and positivity, that's all I want with you. But you push the hell yeah!
It's Logic. Hi, sorry. It's Elton John calling you. I hope you don't mind me getting you on your mobile, or not getting you on your mobile, but I was just congratulating you, first of all, on your performance at the Grammys, and then I was going to ask you if you'd like to do something for me. And I will ring you back later and see and talk about it. Thanks.
Bobby. How are you just going to casually drop that? I'm expecting Elton John to have his ass in the air. He's got his little glasses on. He's got his beads on. Hell yeah. Where is this project? I need a date. I need a time. I need a place. I will fucking be there. See, this sounds like anxiety to me. Yeah, I hear sounds from everybody. It's a nice progression. Okay, personally for me, I think this is the one that I would probably skip over when I go to re-listen to this album. I really like their flow though. Ah. Maybe this one will grow on me. I don't know. It's just okay right now. It's, yeah. Everybody know I be. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Permanently. His like singing has gotten so much better. Him saying that like sold a million records before the radio, that makes me think of him saying, yo, I was successful and I was doing just fine before 1-800 hit the radio and became a massive hit. Obviously he appreciates the success and everything that's happened, but it's like, you know, sometimes you are doing fine even without what people typically would define you as successful. But I'm glad that he's aware of that and he's like, yo, I was doing great, but now I'm doing even better. What up? Like, I don't know. I really like that. Oh, switch up. Hello. Oh, no. Oh, no. What's he gonna do? I feel like the beginning, it was very, like, upbeat and kind of reminiscing about what was Bobby Tarantino. And then as we get further into the album, I feel like it's going a bit in a different direction. And we're gonna start talking about some things that maybe are a little uncomfortable. I'm ready for it though, like bring it on. Damn, he's going off right now. Go for it, please. Oh, I really like the production on this one. I wish it was 2 minutes longer. Like, it's a good length, but I love the production so much. Listen to that. Okay, state of emergency. This makes me think we're gonna get some Logic-esque kind of song. 2 Chainz. I'm not a fan of 2 Chainz, personally. Okay, but he's delivering 2 Chainz? When did 2 Chainz become, like, good? Not to be that bitch, but I was not expecting him to deliver. We might have to reconsider 2 Chainz on this channel. Okay. Wow. Okay, that's not what I thought it would be. However, I'm here for it. Where was that one lyric? So this one right here, you can have rap, I'ma set the whole wide world on fire. I think he truly sees himself as an empire. He's not just gonna limit himself to this. Granted, I don't think he should stop making music. And then this one made me giggle. I ain't in the club throwing dollars, I'm at GameStop, because his nerdy ass. Anyway, next one is What's Up, Big Sean. We fuck with Big Sean on this channel. Mm-hmm. I'm like, what's up, ho? What's up, huh? Oh, here we go. Come on, Big Sean. Fuck it up. Let's go. Why does he sound so cool? Like, hearing him rap, I just imagine him in the studio, like, sunglasses still on, he has a big coat, has, like, a beer or something in his hand, and he's just, like, just talking, just spitting out these bars and killing everybody. Caught that. Did he just do a shout out to Jaden Smith? I still gotta listen to that too. Damn it. I have so much to listen to. Call me Starly Jaden Fool. Yeah, that's the power of will. Oh shit. Okay. How? I'm out of breath just listening to that. That's ridiculous. This one I've been very excited about. Every Day with Marshmello. Marshmello's been killing it lately, right? This is a real interesting melody. Feeling real good. Think you gon' talk shit, you better not. My homies real, it's my day. And no matter what they say, it's my day. Okay, the thing is with this one, he's looking for a radio-friendly single. I feel like this would be the best choice, and I kind of feel like that's why it was made. Isn't just for his demographic, for the Rat Pack, basically. I feel like this is a song you can put on for someone who doesn't really know Bobby, and they would vibe to it. Which, I mean, good for him, you know what I mean? You need songs like that that are accessible to a lot of people. I just can't figure out, though, if I like it or not. I don't know why, like, I can't pinpoint what's making me feel that way. I don't know. 44 more. What does that exactly mean? Just as long as they never say, Daddy blew $20 million. Hey. Bitch, hold up. We gotta talk about that. Sold more albums my first week than Harry Styles and Katy Perry. If that ain't the sign of the Bobby, you fucking clever bastard. Bobby, like, you did not have to step on everyone's throat like that. Honestly, I don't even know what to feel right now. I'm exhausted. We just went through a roller coaster of emotions. However, what I wanted to talk about, which I think was very present in this album, and maybe it's something that he's dealing with personally, and that's why you want to talk about it, was this whole idea of there being two people in him, or two personas. There's the Logic persona, and then there's the Bobby persona. And I don't think there is supposed to be these two personas. I think it's basically the media and the haters and all that making these two people out to be two different people, when it's just basically Logic or Bobby. It's essentially him, you know? This is his genre, this is his thing, he makes great music, but yet he also is spreading the message of peace, love, and positivity. And what is wrong with that, you know? I don't understand why it has to be one or the other. Why can't it be a mixture of both? I feel like he really tackled that very well in this album. And I'm happy that he is experiencing this success, but it's not changing who he is inside. He's not an idiot, he's not a dumbass, God bless. He realizes that he has a platform and he can do good with it. he realizes that this platform may not be here forever and that he needs to be smart about his money and who he works with and what he does. Anyway, that's kind of my take on this. What did you guys think? Let me know in the comments down below. Tell me your favorite tracks, what you didn't like, what you think of the two whole personas of him. Let's chit chat, let's gossip. I wanna know what you're thinking. Of course, don't forget to like and subscribe. Go check out my other channel if you wanna see different type of content besides reactions. And of course, you guys remember to stay weird, honestly, brutal, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.